وسلم laughing after this hadith and smiling until I was able to see his teeth. So that is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the basics that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant the believers on the day of reckoning and on the time of al-hisab by turning their bad deeds into good deeds. The other thing and the other rule that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put on the day, on that day, that He will multiply the good deeds. He will multiply the good deeds. And this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will multiply the good deeds. And that is for the believers. And that is for those who establish the tawheed. And that is for those who obeyed Allah and who deserve such a word. Not for someone who put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aside and who put the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aside. And when he was reminded, he would not care. And when he was told to obey Allah, he will say, I obey whatever I think is right. And I obey the logic. And I obey what makes sense to me. And put the sharia of Allah and the book of Allah on the side. Doesn't look at it. Doesn't care about it. Not only that, but he will fight it. Someone like that doesn't deserve that blessing. So there are people who deserve for their, or who will get their good deeds multiplied. Many folds. Many, many folds. And as we know, some of them will get their deeds multiplied 10 times. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من عمل حسنة فله عشر أمثالها. Whoever does a good deed, he will have it multiplied 10 times. أو أزيد. As in Hadith Qudsi. أو أزيد. Allah says, or I will give more. وَمَنْ عَمِلَ سَيِّئَةً فَبِمِثْلِهَا أَوْ أَغْفَرُ. And who does a good, bad deed, we will award him or reward him the same. Or we will forgive him. That is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها ومن جاء بالسيئة فلا يجزى إلا مثلها. He who comes with the good deed, we will multiply it 10 times for him. And he who comes with the bad deed, he will be rewarded the same. And he will be punished with the same. With the same sayyiah. Sayyiah is not multiplied. ويقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله تعالى الحسنة بعشر أمثالها أو أزيد والسيئة بمثلها أو أغفر. حسنة, the good deed, is multiplied by 10. Or I will give more. And the bad deed will be given the same. Or I will forgive. ويقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث ابن مسعود الترمذي authentic حديث يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله به حسنة والحسنة بعشر أمثالها لا أقول ألف لا ميم حرف ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that he who reads one letter from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be rewarded a good deed. And then he says, and the good deed is multiplied by 10. Then he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, ألا إني لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف. I don't say ألف لام ميم حرف. I don't say ألف لام ميم is one letter, but ألف is one letter, and لام is one letter, and ميم is one letter. So just by reading ألف لام ميم, ألف لام ميم, you got 30 good deeds. والله يضاعف لمن يشاء. ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء. And Allah multiplied to whomever He wants, as many folds as He wants. So be aware of that. And also there are people who will be rewarded more than that, more than 10 times, 70,000 times, or 70 times. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى 700 times. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة 100 حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the example of those who spend in the way of Allah. مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله. It's like a seed that gave growth. حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل, gave growth for 7 ears of wheat. You know the wheat is in ears and in cones like, And each cone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, each ear will have 100 seeds. So one seed gives reward for 700 and give growth to 700 seeds. So that is the multiplication of folds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives some people. وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give even more to whomever He wants. And that is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give even more than 700. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث القدسي قال الله تعالى كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصيام فإنه لي وأنا جزي به. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the hadith al-Qudusi, all of the actions and all of the deeds of the son of Adam for him, except fasting, it's for me. And this hadith can mean many things. But the point is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and I reward for it. Allah rewards for everything. But the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will specifically mention the siyam and mention fasting is because of the greatness of the reward and the greatness of the hasanat that the person will be given and the good deeds. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Indeed, the patient ones will be given their rewards without any account. So imagine what it is. Imagine when it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the one who's giving. Imagine when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who's being generous. What you expect from him? Imagine. All generous. Kareem. What you think he's gonna give you? إِنَّمَا الْوَفَى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. There is no accounting for الصَّابِرِينَ. There is nothing. You come and you take. That's why patient can fall into this. Fasting. Because it requires a lot of patience. وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ. So that is the second thing. So the first, for the believers, Allah turns their bad deeds into good deeds. The second rule, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply many, many folds the good deeds of the believers. The third, إقامت الشهود على العباد. The third rule on the day of judgment, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would implement on that day, is He will establish the testimony and He will establish the witnesses on the slaves. So it's not like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come and say, you did this, 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 this. Your bad deeds more than your good deeds, you're in hellfire. Allah would not do that. He can if He wants. And no one can ask Him why. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to establish the full justice. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want to leave anyone any excuse and anything to make up and say Allah is unfair. He did not give me a chance to defend myself. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will establish the witnesses. And the greatest witness amongst all is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest witness. What witness after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you want? قال الله تعالى إن الله كان على كل شيء شهيدا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testifies and witnesses on everything. Allah witnesses everything. And Allah sees everything. And Allah hears everything. And Allah knows about everything. So that is the greatest witness that you want. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Malik is the witness. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the rusuls and the messengers and the prophets to testify. To testify. And we already talked about that last time. They will testify. Allah will bring Nuh. Ya Nuh, did you fulfill your message? Yes, I did. Then we'll ask the people of Nuh, did you hear? Did he deliver? They will say, we don't know. We did not hear from him. Nuh, 950 years. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using Nuh as a witness. Then Allah will bring the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You and I. Allah will bring me and bring you and bring the Muslims to testify for Nuh alayhi salam. So very important, the Rusul or the Prophets and the Messengers will be also used to testify on the nations. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will testify on us as we are his Ummah. And will testify for other Messengers. قال الله تعالى وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا لتكونوا شهداء على الناس ويكون الرسول عليكم شهيدا. This is how we made you an Ummah in the middle so you can testify for people and the Prophet will testify on you. And we have already talked about that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا.